Technology in this day and age appears to be an essential driving force of the world around us. It seems as if neither nature nor culture can be thought of without contrasting it to technics. In this video, the accounts of George Dyson, Samuel Butler, and Gilles Deleuze on technics as an autonomous entity will be explored. Historically, it is ambiguous at which time technology as a driving force in itself became an object of investigation in science and philosophy. George Dyson gives accounts of early Enlightenment philosophers such as Thomas Hobbes that appear to have already worked with a proto-cybernetic model of society. Cybernetics, in this case, denotes a system or network which derives its characteristic dynamics from the interaction of humans and machines of various kinds. In the Hobbesian conception, the state represents Leviathan, a living entity composed of a multiplicity of humans connected in a state economic system. The Leviathan is not only comprised of humans of various professions, but also of ships, carriages, horses, tools, windmills, etc. This conception constructs an overarching cybernetic entity to the singular individual, which is only partially comprised of human agents. The first explicit characterization of technics itself as an autonomous entity was given by Samuel Butler in 1863, in which he expressed a critique of Darwin's understanding of evolution by applying Darwinism to machines. Quote, "There is no security against the ultimate development of mechanical consciousness in the fact of machines possessing little consciousness now. A mollusk has not much consciousness. Reflect upon the extraordinary advance which machines have made during the last few hundred years, and note how slowly the animal and vegetable kingdoms are advancing. The more highly organized machines are creatures not so much of yesterday as of the last 5 minutes, so to speak, in comparison with past time." Butler attempted a synthesis between the competing theories of evolution and intelligent design by introducing an intelligent element to the environment of a species. The modification of the human environment was not seen by Butler as a mere exteriorization of human cognitive faculties. Instead, machines represented a species of another qualitative nature that was co-evolving in codependency with humans. This co-development enabled the emergence of human intelligence by extending human rational capabilities. Whilst Butler's ideas have not been given much attention in the field of biology, they were studied by various philosophical, historical, and sociological writers on the theory of technology. Deleuze and Guattari expressed great interest in Butler's conception of machines and implemented in their framework of describing capitalist society a cybernetic system of machines. Quote, "Everywhere it is machines, real ones, not figurative ones, machines driving other machines, machines being driven by other machines, with all the necessary couplings and connections. An organ machine is plugged into an energy source machine. The one produces a flow that the other interrupts. The breast is a machine that produces milk and the mouth machine coupled to it. The mouth of the anorexic wavers between several functions. Its possessor is uncertain as to whether it is an eating machine, an anal machine, a talking machine, or a breathing machine. Hence we are all handymen, each with his little machines, for every organ machine and energy machine. All the time, flows and interruptions." Their understanding of capital can be regarded as the most extreme conception of autonomous technology, as it purports a self-assembling entity termed the body without organs, of which the capitalist age is a mere preliminary stage. Capital disassembles or deterritorializes human society, agency, and autonomy, and reconfigures or re-territorializes them into a form that generates production. The overall trajectory, however, leads towards deterritorialization, which means that eventually human agency is entirely disintegrated due to a determinism that drives evolution towards the point of human dissolution. This is often conceptualized as the point of technological singularity. Quote by Nick Land. The story goes like this. Earth is captured by a techno-capitalist singularity as Renaissance rationalization and oceanic navigation lock into commoditization takeoff. Logistically accelerating techno-economic interactivity crumbles social order in auto-sophisticating machine runaway. As markets learn to manufacture intelligence, politics modernizes, upgrades paranoia, and tries to get a grip. This notion of the loss of human freedom due to technology has been brought up frequently by critics of Technics such as Martin Heidegger, Jacques Ellul, or Theodor Kaczynski. Thank you for listening thus far, and I will end this talk with a quote by Samuel Butler. Day by day, however, the machines are gaining ground upon us. Day by day, we are becoming more subservient to them. More men are daily bound down as slaves to tend them. More men are daily devoting the energies of their whole lives to the development of mechanical life. The upshot is simply a question of time, but that the time will come when the machines will hold the real supremacy over the world and its inhabitants is what no person of a truly philosophic mind can for a moment question.